Hello family, welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you a very delicious dinner recipe. As you seen in the beginning of the video and on my thumbnail. So, without wasting much time, let's get to today's video. So guys, I'm just going to start by peeling my arrowroot, or as you know it, taro or nduma. So I'm just going to peel my nduma well as shown in the video. So for this particular recipe, I just used one large nduma that I've shown you. So I'll leave you to watch me peel my nduma and I'll be right back. Guys, after peeling my arrowroot, I'm now just going to thoroughly wash it as shown in the video. Just going to chop my arrowroot into my desired sizes as shown in the video. So I need you to watch me chop my arrowroot to tiny sizes and I'll be right back. The same that we are going to be working with today. As you can see, I'm really showing you the size that I used. So what I'm going to do now is to wash my arrowroot as shown in the video. My arrowroots, I'm now just going to add them to a pot. I'm then going to add some water to slightly cover my arrowroots as shown in the video. I'm also going to add some salt to taste, and then I'm going to cover my arrowroots with a foil. You can also use a polythene, it works for me too. And then all I'm going to do is to cover my arrowroots with the lid again. Well, as shown in the video. So I'm going to want that now and I'll be right back. I'm now just going to fire up my stove and add my arrowroot pot, and then cook my marrow beef and peel pork tender. So guys, moving on, as our harrow roots is still cooking, I'm not just going to prepare our lentils. We are going to be having lentils cool. So all I'm going to do is to measure the desired quantity that I want, and then all I'm going to do is to wash my lentils well, as shown in the video. So you can also use the yellow lentils without cover, but for this particular video, this is the lentils that I have today. So this is what I'm going to use. I'm just going to wash my lentils and then I'm going to add them to a pot, as shown in the video. And then all I'm going to do is to add some water to my lentils, as shown in the video. I'm also going to add some salt to taste, and then I'm going to set my lentils aside. Moving on, after a while I'm now just going to check on our harrow roots. Our harrow roots are now boiled, fully boiled to fork tender. So as you can see, I'm just showing you closely how our harrow roots look. So I'm just going to set my harrow roots aside, and then I'm going to add my pot of lentils to the stove. I'm also going to cook my lentils until they are tender. So guys, I'm not going to show you all through the way I'm grilling my lentils, because this is too long for that. So guys, as you can see, after a while our lentils are now tender. I'm just going to remove them from the stove and set them aside. So moving on to that pot that you can see right there, I'm just going to add some oil to it, and then I'm going to preheat my oil until it's a little hot, and then I'm going to add one medium sized chopped red onion. You can use whichever onion you have for this recipe, guys. I'm also going to add 1 tablespoon ginger and garlic paste, and then all I'm going to do is to mix my onions together with my ginger and garlic paste. And then all I'm going to do is to let my onions fry to golden brown. So guys, I'll leave you to watch that and I'll be right back. After a few minutes, my onions are now golden brown. I'm now just going to add my 2 medium sized chopped tomatoes. I'm then going to mix well again, as shown in the video. And then all I'm going to do is to cover my pot so my tomatoes can soften. So after a few minutes again, I'm now just going to uncover my pot, and then I'm going to mix well again, as shown in the video. So guys, I'm now just going to add some of my black pepper to taste, and then I'm going to add our cooked lentils that we set aside, and then all I'm going to do is to give it a quick mix, as shown in the video. So guys, that is it for our lentils. I just made it that simple and clear, as you can see. You can add any of your spices that you like, but for me, that is it for me for my lentils. So all I'm going to do now is to test. Guys, you have to test your food to know if you need to adjust any salt or any spice that you like. So moving on to my preheated pan, I'm going to set my lentils aside first, and then moving on, I'm now going to add some oil to my preheated pan, and then all I'm going to do is to add 1 tablespoon fresh crushed ginger. I'm also going to add some of my chopped green pepper, and then all I'm going to do is to fry this mixture for a little while, as shown in the video. So I'm going to work back in the grind. So guys, after frying my peppers for a little while, I'm now just going to add my 3 medium sized chopped tomatoes, and then all I'm going to do is to cover my pan with a lid, and then after a while I'm going to uncover my pan, and then I'm now just making sure all my tomatoes are soft. If you are working with a pan, it's always hard. I'm sorry, I meant it's always hard for the tomatoes to fully soften. So I'm just making sure my tomatoes are really soft. So I'm now just going to break my 2 Royco cubes as shown in the video. So guys, you can replace the Royco cubes with your favorite seasoning, but for me, I'm going to use my Royco cubes. I'm also going to add some of my fresh chopped coriander as shown in the video. Then all I'm going to do is to mix everything well together. So I need to work that for a while. So guys, right now I'm just going to add our cooked taro roots, and then all I'm going to do is to mix my taro roots gently. So guys, you can just use a fork for this to make sure you don't break your taro roots so much. So I'll leave you to watch me for a while and I'll be right back. Guys, right now my voice is almost breaking. As you can see, our arrowroots are now ready, but for me, I'm just going to add some water because my tomatoes are a little stuck at the bottom of my pan. I'm just going to add some water, and then I'm going to give it a quick mix as shown in the video, gently. And then all I'm going to do is to cook this for a while. So guys, you have to use low heat for this so that your arrowroots don't burn. So I'll leave it to add that for a while and I'll be right back. guys, as you can see right now, our Haro roots are ready, and I love this recipe. Guys, you have to try this recipe. This dinner recipe was so good. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment section below, and make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. And thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.